Today, I'm going to reveal one of the secrets that has made me thousands of dollars in the past years. It's a website scraper that has filled my sites with content. Now, I am affiliated to these sites, so it helps me grab the content and start promoting right away. Let me show you what I'm talking about right now. The scraper that I'm talking about is called WP Automatic, and it's extremely powerful and it's easy to use once you get the hang of it. It's my favorite scraper that I'm using on all my sites. Now, before I show you how to set one of these babies up, let me show you what you can connect to with WP Automatic. So they've just added OpenAI. So aside from just being a scraper, it can also generate content using AI. You can auto post from RSS feeds. So if you are an affiliate from a specific site and they have an RSS feed, you can pull the content from there. Okay, you can auto post from almost any website. You can pull content from any website, auto post from Amazon, eBay, AliExpress, ClickBank, Envato, Craigslist, and all these Twitter, Instagram, Pinterest, YouTube, etc., TikTok, and do it from this plugin. So it's extremely useful. Now, on this site where I'm actually using it, I am pulling from Amazon store, and I've pulled the 902 products from the store using this plugin. I'm not doing it manually. I just set it up and it's a set and forget system. Now, the first thing I would recommend is once you install the plugin and add the license, go into settings, and in the settings, set up what you need to add. So for example, if you are going to use the Amazon settings, well, set up your account here. There's also other settings to use ClickBank, AliExpress, etc. The OpenAI API, you're gonna add it here and all that good stuff. Now, why are we here? Well, to see how powerful it actually is. Now, let me show you, let me remove these notices here. Okay, there we go. We're gonna title this test for video, and we have several options available. Like I said before, they have all these sections to pull information. Now, I'm going to use the multi-page scraper for this test just to show you how good it actually is. Now, the first thing that it's going to ask me is how many posts do I want to make this in total? So you could set it all the way to 1 million, and it's gonna post every frequently these minutes, hours, or days. So it doesn't have to be like frequently one after another. You can set it up, especially if you don't want to crash your site, right? You want to give it some time. Now, what do I want to pull from? Let's just say that I'm going to pull from this store, which is some really cool t-shirts that they have. They're actually giving me some of these. So I'm going to use this link, all right? Let's just say that I'm an affiliate for this page, and well, they're not going to provide me anything. Or if they provide me, they're going to give me the bunch of images and the bunch of text, and it's going to be super hard to pull all this information. So I'm going to use WP Automatic to do it. So I'm going to grab the title for this. Let me go back into my settings, and I'm going to add it here. Now it's going to ask me, link, single item extraction method. So it wants to know which one is the first link. So I'm gonna click on this dot, and it's going to open up a visual selector, okay? So I'm here and I'm gonna select the first product from this section, all right? And then it's gonna ask me for several of these options. Now there's gonna be a whole bunch of options, and you're gonna go through these one by one and see what you need to activate or deactivate. It's gonna be super long if I go into every single one of these. Now there's options that are, for example, check the top post, will ignore the older posts. So just only the new post, add post with its original time. So for example, if it has timing, you can do it like that. And there's a bunch of settings. Let me go into the important ones. For example, skip post with no content, skip post with no images. So it's just like things that you want to set up, right? And there's also the content extraction method. It's the auto detect full content. If it doesn't detect it in your settings, you can also, again, use the visual selector or use the CSS selector or the content using rejects, all right? So whatever you want to use if it doesn't work with the automatic pull, all right? So like I said, there's several settings. Now, there's the variables that we can use, the original title, and we can add something to this, like, I don't know, t-shirts. So it's gonna grab the original title and add that to it. And then there's also the variables for the content. So inside of here, for example, there's a source link. If you don't wanna put the source link, you can remove this. If you wanna add your own link, you can do it here via HTML and just add there. If you wanna add a buy button, you can do it here, all right? And there's other variables available here. The post type, so in this case, it's gonna be a post, a page, an attachment, etc. In this case, we wanna make it a post, right? If we're gonna set a, what other one? Post author, if you wanna set an author for this, we'll leave it at admin. New post status. So let's just say that you don't want to go straight away to publish because you want to make sure that everything's working fine. Well, you can do draft, okay? Private or pending. If you're good to go, use publish. In this case, I'll do a draft, all right? And other important settings is the image. So if you want to strip the first image to content to use as a featured image, you can select that. Try to generate the name of the image from the post title, set title of the image as the media library post, set image alt text automatically, check the image width. I'm not gonna do that now. Other things that I do all the time is, for example, download image from the server content. So again, let's add that there. So that's in case you wanna add it to your own file. So it's gonna download the image and add it to your files. So it's not gonna pull it from the original site. Next we have is categories. So if you wanna tie this to certain categories, you can do so here. Keyword to category, so it adds that there also. So if it's a category for t-shirts, well, yeah, you wanna add that keyword to the category, right? Post title specific tags, title words as tags. So for example, it's gonna grab the title and add those as keywords. So super useful and powerful. Post filters, you can go through these, like I said. The rewriting, if you wanna rewrite this or translate it. So like I said, I'm using this for the Amazon store, and if I want to translate it, I'll use this. So it's super easy to use, all right? There's a content search replace modifications. So if you wanna replace certain words, keywords, etc., if you wanna remove hyperlinks, you can do so here. The links settings for it here. So strip original links from the post. If you wanna remove the hyperlinks, if you wanna strip these, if you wanna make them no follow, so you can add no follow here. A lot of settings, miscellaneous. Okay, so let's get started with this test. Let's go ahead and publish. Okay, let's go ahead and leave. There we go. Let's go ahead and click play, and it's gonna pull the information from the first product, okay? There we go, it pulled it automatically. Here's the date, and here's the title for it. So it's the last post, which is this one, right? It just pulled it right now. And now it's in my site. So let's go open this in a new tab. There we go, here's the image there. That's an ad that I have there, and the information for it. Now in this case, there's no content, and I'll show you proof of this. Let me go ahead and open it up. This is all the content that it has, okay? But if it had content and it didn't grab it, like I said, you can use the visual selector to select that part of the content. Okay, let's go back into my post. Here we go. Okay, so it pulled the first product. Now let's, like I said, this is a set and forget. Now in this case, I published it and it says it's gonna post the next one in 60 minutes. I can do these every 24 hours, every 2 hours, whatever I wanna set it. But I'm going to do it manually. So I'm gonna click play. Let's just say that this is again, starting in 60 minutes automatically. So it's gonna pull the next content. Remember, I can set this to just go and grab all the content, or I can set it to only post when it adds a new t-shirt. Now, if they add a new t-shirt here, it's gonna automatically add it to my site. I don't have to do anything. It's a set and forget. You can even set a date, for example, only add t-shirts that were added from 6 months and now, right? So you can do it like that, or 6 months and before. So you can have all those settings there. Like I said, it's super powerful. I'm gonna move this to the trash can because I'm not going to use it. And I'm going to give you another example. Let's just say that we want to use OpenAI, which is something they just added. So OpenAI, I'm just gonna name it like that. OpenAI GPT-3 articles. Now remember, I added the API already in my settings. And yes, OpenAI does have a cost for every single pull that we do. Now it's going to ask me for keywords or phrases that I want to use. Now, heads up, I already tested this in Spanish and it does work. So if you write the phrase that you are looking for in Spanish or Turkish or whatever, it's gonna automatically detect it and put it in your language. So in this case, let's just say that I'm gonna say top Amazon cameras for noobs, all right? And I can add another camera and add several titles so it starts generating different contents. In this case, I'm gonna do it with just this one for testing, okay? So I can do suggest articles titles about, and I can modify this. Article content generate prompt. How many times to call OpenAI GPT-3. I'm gonna do it once. And then we have all the settings that we had before, like pull the images. Now something I would recommend if you're using OpenAI is to actually add the API also for Pixabay. So it adds an image that's related to the content automatically, all right? In this case, I'm not gonna add Pixabay for now. I'm gonna publish, okay? So I wanna show you how easy this is, all right? And it's gonna generate something with this title that I've added. So I'm gonna click play, and it will take around less than a minute to generate the content. So let's give it some time. There we go, it generated the content, and there it is. Best cameras for beginners on Amazon. Let's go into another tab, open this one, and this content was generated automatically, okay? Using OpenAI. Now, if I click play again, it'll generate another piece of content automatically. Now, remember, this is gonna run automatically every 60 minutes. And you can see it added some suggested titles for this, and it grabbed one of them. And it'll do again and again and do more content automatically. So WP Automatic is not just a website scraper. It can also generate content. And this is brand new. OpenAI was added from this video like 3 days ago. So this is going to get way more powerful as it starts developing with the next updates. But there you go. That is WP Automatic. You can start pulling content for your affiliate sites or other reasons that you might want to use this. So it's extremely useful to start adding content to your website with this plugin. But there you go. If you want to grab it, the link will be provided in the description. And that's a wrap.